Everyone, it's Alex, and I meant to have this video up on, or at least by Valentine's Day, in which I have another installment in some ongoing videos I have about men. Previously with the F-boy and then also the soft boy, for today's niche men's subgenre, I have the male manipulator. To be completely upfront, this is a video inspired by something that really inspired me around this time last month, and that is with the West Elm Caleb TikTok journey that I experienced and think fondly of, but which is also like kind of horrifying. Basically, what happened with the concept of West Elm Caleb on TikTok is that there was this guy in New York City named Caleb who notoriously was dating all of these women at the same time without their knowledge. And all of these women, I think, kept finding each other based on the algorithm of TikTok, just realizing they were all referring to this guy that would work at West Elm, and he was like 6'4" and he liked art and stuff. So they sort of all realized they were all talking about the same person. And I don't think it was ever like a basis of him confirming he was exclusive with anybody. So I don't think he was at least cheating on anyone. But I do think it was kind of slimy that he was basically copying and pasting the exact same text conversations he was having with all these different women. And I think the cherry on top being that he made this Spotify playlist and it had all the same songs, but he would just, I think, change the name of the girl to the title of the Spotify playlist, so it felt really unique, and like catered to them and stuff. And really the whole thing became like an internet phenomenon of women rallying together to take down this guy that was, you know, trying to be a player with trying to talk to all of them. But that horrifying aspect I was mentioning earlier, I think, is that basis of whenever like brands sort of started to capitalize off of West Elm Caleb by like referencing him or yada yada with an Instagram post or something just relating to like, you know, the millennials or the youths. Which I mean, to be honest, like anything with the internet, it's kind of like long past already. Like, I don't think anyone's talking about West Elm Caleb anymore, but it's very strange to me, like the basis of becoming a public figure of sorts, and what this does with like a sense of privacy with this Caleb guy being a real person. But what's fascinating to me on this basis of how quickly and like this immediacy of like labeling who West Elm Caleb is, like as a giant signifier, not only for himself as a person, but like all men and like their dating practices or whatever. It made me think of things like the meme of the phrase male manipulator, which for me at least, I've heard its origins on the basis of things like Spotify playlist, like maybe with some red flags of certain musicians or bands or artists that are featured that a lot of men mention. And to quote from a source being Urban Dictionary, they define a male manipulator, or really I should say male manipulator music, because it's usually just tied to music, a meme that originated on the app TikTok about a specific subculture of music. The joke is something along the lines of, if they listen to this music, run. Examples of male manipulator music are Radiohead, The Smiths, The Cure, etc. And the reason I find male manipulator or male manipulator music interesting, because I think of the overlap between like other male signifiers like the F-boy or the soft boy. I think it's just funny because like men having these signifiers whenever it feels like a contrast to like how often women unfortunately are made fun of for just liking stuff. So now like guys have this kind of stuff that they like may fit into a tier two. And of course all of this is in jest. Like none of it is serious. I would hope whoever's like a victim of this kind of identity realizes, but with West Elm Caleb, it's just funny to think of his Spotify playlist with things like LCD Sound System, Tame Impala, Angel Olsen, which is a bit of a wild card to me. And immediately, as soon as I saw Avril 14th by Aphex Twin, I knew that was like the red flag of all red flags. And I know with this context of me talking about all these things like F-boys or soft boys or male manipulators, it can be kind of confusing. So just so we're all on the same page before I dive into the real part of this video that I think people are actually interested in, I will put a Venn diagram of how everyone can, you know, catch up to speed. So basically what I wanted to do is, based on West Elm Caleb as a persona, but also thinking of like who I think he is based on his Spotify playlist, I kind of do wonder what books he would own, or basically what are books that West Elm Caleb may justify as like reasons as to why he maybe brings them up to his dates, in which I think it might match his, persona, like I mentioned earlier. And of course, as to not create a bias or assumption or whatever, these are all books, of course, that I've read myself. So, having a little bit of authority on them just based on my subjective opinion. So, my first line of thought is that Westholm Caleb would need a book that proves he's vulnerable. So, I'm gonna say A Single Man by Christopher Isherwood. Nothing seems more vulnerable to me than maybe Westholm Caleb having reflected on his childhood and having like a guy best friend that he thought he maybe had a crush on, and maybe telling his date that so it proves that he's like open-minded or like willing to share that kind of stuff, when really he might just be someone that finds something like the Tom Ford adaptation of A Single Man to have just been aesthetically pleasing and confusing it with sexuality. A Single Man follows a man named George late in the 1960s, if I remember correctly. And we're introduced to George as he's actually going through quite a lot of grief, having just lost his partner, who's also a man. So, thinking of the 1960s, it's kind of easy to understand the context of maybe how George is able to express his grief. I really love this book because I think, under the context of the 1960s, where homosexuality is still something to tiptoe around, I do think it is a basis of George organically trying to still process that just because he was in a relationship with someone, another man, doesn't mean he's fully outgrown the concept of what his own sexuality means to him. Perhaps even defining his ability to accept who he is based on the failure of realizing his partner has died. So I think it's really interesting and a little psychological in a way, too, of how Christopher Isherwood painted this story, and it's so short too, so it like manages to do so much in so little. Up next, I would think Westholm Caleb needs a book that he feels okay mansplaining to someone, and for that I would say Master and Margarita by Mikhail Bulgakov. To be honest, I remember being really confused reading this book too, just because it's full of hijinks. The best way I think describing it being that it's essentially a roller coaster that's being conducted by the devil. But what's really fun is that I think Bulgakov manages to paint these really descriptive parts that are like really like proving his imagination, but how he's so good at quickly turning a scenario into something really nightmarish. But I can just imagine Westholm Caleb like introducing this to a date, even though the date has said they already read it, but Caleb trying to like prove the true meaning of the book or something. But I think Master and Margarita is a book that definitely, at least for me, was more rewarding when I kind of let go and just released myself to, again, those kind of hijinks of the tone of the story, other than me trying to read it too deeply. The third book I would think Westholm Caleb needs to secure is one that proves he's woke. So I would definitely have to say We Should All Be Feminist by Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie. This is a little book of nonfiction where Adichie basically gives a perspective of what 21st century feminism is like. But picking this one's kind of funny because I could imagine Westholm Caleb like flipping through this book in a bookstore while waiting for his date or something. Although picking this book too is kind of funny because I know with Adichie, it's been a basis of how she's had some backlash with her comments on things like trans women. And I know I heard that last summer, I think, she came out with another essay that was trying to expand and basically talk about things like social media and cancel culture, which is so funny because the same is kind of the idea behind Westholm Caleb becoming this figure of like men and how they interact with the internet. And I haven't read that essay, but I think it's just, it would be kind of ironic, like if Westholm Caleb, without his knowledge, didn't understand the context of Adichie's personal past recently on the basis of things like cancel culture and stuff like that. For my fourth book, I would say that Westholm Caleb needs a book that's buzzy, so like he's in the know, and I think he would pick maybe something like Beautiful World, Where Are You by Sally Rooney. And I think specifically the reason he would choose this one is to determine whether or not he can feel like Felix or Simon in the book, or maybe even trying to argue that he's both of them. This novel follows Felix and Simon, but also two other characters, Alice and Eileen. And the book initially progresses through Alice and Eileen sending emails to each other up until they eventually plan to meet each other, since it's been a long time since they've done that. And all the while, I think Rooney does a good job at really sharing these projections of the four characters really thinking about each other and how often incorrect they are. I really liked this book from a content level of the idea behind a group of people that are very like-minded with each other, so trying to find little ways in which they could argue or engage and try to sort of see how they can interact, I think was really interesting. But from a structural level, I do think this book is a bit weak in a sense of trying to stay with me. I think mainly because of the emails, which in my opinion, I don't think were that great. And also Rooney's sense of this elongated tension, I think. And I think that does come with the territory of how Alice, Eileen, Felix, and Simon are so similar that it kind of feels like its own vacuum of like these intellectual conversations that it feels a bit one note in its own way. Even if I do think it's accurate that people who like exist more than likely try to gravitate towards those people that think like them. So I think in that way it was kind of interesting to read about. And finally we have what Westcott Caleb answers as his favorite novel. And I would actually say The Last Samurai by Helen DeWitt. This novel follows a mother and a son as they both bond over watching a movie called The Seventh Samurai. But all the while the book does have an emphasis on trying to really think about the social constructions of masculinity as one particular theme. Since the son Ludo, who is often very curious and intellectual, is a way of him, the novel basically following how he's trying to figure out who his absent father is, again, tying back maybe into those themes of masculinity. But with that sense of being an intellectual, Ludo does often, at a very young age, I think even like 9 or 10, he reads all these other languages, and if I remember right, he reads Homer. And the book in that way is really playful without ever feeling condescending with DeWitt managing a child character, which I think, as is pretty hard to try to portray whenever obviously writing as an adult. Leading me to say that my favorite thing about this book is actually Ludo's narration, and I think between sometimes the flickering different perspectives of Ludo and his mother, I think it really helps put a grasp on things. And really how this book is really driven by this self-education and really big enthusiasm for just trying to figure out who you are and what you like and what you want. And it's written so well. I think this is probably one of the best, like objectively, one of the best books I've read in terms of like writing and stuff. And it's so inventive and feels fresh and original. And I think Westcott Caleb would eat this up, definitely claiming that he himself feels like he was Ludo whenever he was younger, when really he just probably has daddy issues. And that does it. Those are all the books, or at least a few of them, that maybe you can be on the lookout for any potential male manipulators in your life. As for my own reading, I've been reading a lot of good stuff recently that I think I'll talk about soon in an upcoming video. But until then, as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.